take him up and throw in the air. And in the midair, in the silver gravity, the child will smile. Because it doesn't have fear. I went to Wanderla from team outing, from office, where all this harness, with all this protection gear, still when it goes down, we scream. I had a friend who was murmuring and I asked him what is happening. He's telling I'm telling Saraswati Mantra. When I was a child, on my annual day in LKG, there was a gap between some programs and my teacher told everyone, come and tell a story. I went and told a story without a fear. But now, standing here after 5 speeches, going to division level, still my hands are shivering. This is my, when he told about the childhood memories, this is what I want to convey. Be fearless like a child. When you stand here or do any activity, be fearless. With that, let me start my evaluation process. So, I would like to call Kushal to have a report on Shiva.
Sometimes I actually was searching some good quotes for the icebreaker speech. So I came across one good quote that sometimes what you are most afraid of doing is the very thing that will set you free. So today we have witnessed that we saw that, you know, the confidence level, that this was the first speech of Shiva. And I think from your speech, you have gained a lot of confidence and that pushed you for this table topic speech as well. I think that was the first table topic speech also. So congratulations, Shiva, on completing your first icebreaker speech. Coming to your speech evaluation, it was really interactive speech. The way you have presented your story, right, it was a very innovative way of telling a story of a boy and then relating it and telling your story. It was like something you are telling, we are listening some movie story. So it was very well presented by, with this different way. One of the good thing I observed while you were giving speech was your smile. Throughout the speech you were smiling. That's really good thing that you were enjoying actually, and you also made sure that audience is also engaged in your story, and now and there you were asking response from the public and you were addressing their answer, means response, you are addressing all the comments. Also, one good thing I noticed that some of us who have already given icebreaker speech used a note while giving the speech, but you did not use it. That's really a good thing I have seen. So that shows that you are very well confident that you will deliver your speech really well. So congratulations for that also. Coming to the improvement area, right? So this was your first speech. I observed that the stage presence, coming to the gestures, right, body language. So you would have used this stage appropriately. You were just moving from like front and back. You could have used the stage very well while giving your speech. Eye contact was good, but still I will suggest that you try to make eye contact to most of the people in the hall. Your vocal variety, you could have used your tone giving when you were giving the example of where you were stuck between the cow huddle or maybe your father met with an accident. You could have used variation in your voice to give the impression to the audience so that they can really connect with your speech. But overall, coming to the conclusion, I think you have select your title was appropriate, and in the end even you justified that you have to always be ready with the unknown, and you very well correlated that title with your speech. So really good selection of your title speech as well. And yeah, as you mentioned right at the start of your speech, that if you are sleeping at the end of the speech, you are enjoying it as like good speech, but if you are awake, then you are, I think I forgot that, but I think people were awake at the end of your speech, so everyone enjoyed your speech. So congratulations, Shiva, for your speech.
have written 2 points more of Shiva. You had your speech fully written in third person. That is one mistake which we do in P1. We keep talking about yourself, my, me, I. It becomes boring. But when you told about a little boy, it was more interesting. Thank you, Kushal. That was a very nice evaluation. You covered most of the topics of my points, so I couldn't tell more. Another point for Shiva is, I hope the timings were a little more. Prepare it with timing so that you'll never break that. Now let me call Chitra for evaluation of Ishida.
Good afternoon, everyone. So, Alia Bhatt of Red says, you have a very sweet and endearing voice. In fact, when you started speaking on the topic and everyone got the idea what the topic would be, I thought the speech was a little contrary or antithetical to your personality as such. You have a very effervescent personality, right? But I think you challenged yourself there, because even though it was something that we don't relate with you, you delivered a very good speech, I thought, right? So for your speech had a very important message. There's a quote that it's the simple thing in lives that things in life that make the bulk of it. Mundane is where we live and we end up missing most of it. I think your speech towards the end captured that really well. But what I would say is the message itself was delivered towards the fag end of the speech. Maybe you could have wrapped that up a little bit sooner and brought a little more variety to the speech itself, right? But all having said that, your voice modulation was excellent. It was like watching a play on the stage. You were going back and forth on both sides, using the stage really well. And for the most parts, your hand gestures were really good. But many instances, your hands were clasped together. I don't know how to solve that problem because I myself have that issue. But yeah, that is something that all of us need to work on, right? Other than that, I have this habit while traveling, I listen to BBC radio dramas. So while listening to your speech, it felt like I'm doing that. With your voice modulation and the way you were playing the child and the father, it was extremely interesting as audience to listen to the speech as such, right? And the words that you used, it was a very interesting speech. Most of us thought that we are listening to something that is produced on the stage, right? I have few minor, like simple questions for the audience just to test whether you listen. So how much was the father making per hour?
1,000.
And how much does the child want?
300.
Good. So the most important parts people were listening at least. So you were able to engage the audience really well. But probably a little more interaction with the audience would have been nice. Because when you were going back and forth, like people thought they were watching a movie or a drama, right? So it was very little eye contact for most parts of the speech. Maybe although the content itself was like that. So that's why I was saying if you had shortened that content and had a little bit more around the speech where you can look and address the audience, it would have been a little bit more engaging speech. But overall, it was a very good speech as such, very interesting, and had a very important message towards the end. So congratulations.
Thank you, Chitra. That was very nice evaluation. I hope she gets more input. Did you evaluate the first speech?
No, this is the first.
Oh, this is the speech. Okay. Since I was not there last time, I thought the second speech. Ishida, I would like to add a few more points. I really look forward to see the second speech, because if this is the first one, I would really want to see the second one. Second thing is, I thought you really listened to Avinash's speech, because you were putting information which Avinash was delivering. It was a well-delivered speech, and I hope you have more success in future. With that, we conclude the evaluation of prepared speeches. I would like to add a few points for Avinash also. First of all, it's an exceptional speech. Second thing is, you did a one wonderful thing. Instead of taking examples, you made your speech as an example. We have listened to such motivational speeches or this vocal variety and all, but they tell you had to do this and then they tell for an example. Instead of that, you did the speech itself as an example. It was very nice. I really enjoyed it. Most of the times, especially when you are taking the vocal varieties, there was pin drop silence in the audience. Not even a pen was dropping. That was very nice. That shows the grasp you have on the audience. Very good speech. Coming to the other team, the tag team, I would like to call the grammarian to present his report.
Okay, overall it was a very good session in terms of usage of the English language. So to make it more interesting, I'm going to just quote different points and you guys will guess which were good usage and which was bad usage. No, I'm just kidding. Okay, there were very many good words used such as destiny, sheen, larynx, which I'm glad I don't have to actually spell, I just have to pronounce. Falsetto, Benedict Cumberbatch, I consider that as a good usage. And also cello, because most people would say cello, I would. But I would say there are so many good usages, timbre, and not use it in the sense that it's a, actually use it as, in the sense of tone and not as a tree or wood, right? And there was un-self-conscious, that was a creative usage where you're trying to use it the way you want. There were so many intricacy, endearing, antithetical, effervescent. So overall, I felt it was a very good session. And a couple of things I noted in terms of quotes where one, when they're going get stuff, there was a twist and he said, go shopping. And there was also a curious usage where we said that couldn't smell sleep. I'm not sure how that was. So that was one point I wanted to mention. And a couple of other improvements would be hitting like anything, maybe we could. There are other options to describe how it wasn't so good, you know, wavered or abysmal. And then pretty common usage, cannot able to do it, couldn't do it, would be enough. And then there was also an instance where we said, do you know of black magic? I think that was a little confusing for the audience. Because not everybody was aware of it. I wasn't sure if it was intentional though, but it seemed unintentional to me. And besides that, worry for you, maybe we could have said worry about you. So that was overall, and then coming to the word of the day, I'm glad that Kushal and Chitra used the word of the day gestures. So thank you for that. That's my overall report. Thank you guys.
Thank you, Dr. Alan. I would like to call the timer to present the report.
So for the prepared speeches, Shiva took 7 minutes 30.